So let's move on to Shalonda's question. And her question is similar. She says, my grandmother was broadsided by a lady who admitted to running a stop sign. One friend was killed instantly. My grandmother died later. What are their legal rights? Lorelei, where can she go for answers at this point?
Yeah, so that's very similar to JJ's question. I think the heirs, whether they be wrongful death heirs or otherwise, the heirs have right to bring lawsuits for the death of their loved ones. And sometimes it could be more than one person that has that right. Now, you know, ideally, you only want to bring one lawsuit because you want everybody to at least try to work together towards a common goal. But occasionally we find ourselves fighting it out. Both of those families should absolutely hire an attorney to try to get justice for the loss of their loved ones. Keep in mind, we as attorneys, we do have ways after the fact to try to get the facts and find out what truly happened, right? So we might have to take some depositions. We might look to see if there was witnesses. There's discovery. And I know Rocky knows more about this, but the I think there's cameras and stuff sometimes that you find, you know, to see exactly what happened if it was a car accident. And so even if a person has passed and we're not able to get the facts directly from their mouth, there's ways that we can go about getting other information.
Rocky?
Yeah. One other thing I think Laura Lies is nailed on the head as far as what the rights are. But one other thing to look at is there any underinsured motorist coverage or uninsured motorist coverage available to your grandmother and also the other person that was hurt? Because what we don't know is the person that ran the stop sign, did they have insurance coverage? And if they didn't, then you've got to look at your own coverage. And if they did, is it enough? Is it $25,000, which wouldn't scratch the surface for what these injuries are? I mean, they're no amount of money, but certainly not $25,000. And so hopefully there's uninsured or underinsured motorist coverage available, which we'd have to know more facts, but if that's available, then it would allow at least some sort of recovery, because the worst thing that could happen in a situation like this is the person that caused it didn't have insurance. And then you go to your client and you say, okay, you know, the family member, what kind of coverage was available? And they say, well, they opted out of getting UM coverage. They rejected it to save money. That will make a terrible situation worse, is when there's no avenue of recovery for these injuries and losses.